Dear friends, welcome back. This is Nick. Today, I want to talk about a board that has caught my eye, the Inkplate 2, a compact e-paper display board. If you have followed my work, you know I am fascinated by e-paper displays, and this one offers something interesting for makers. It is small, versatile, and packs everything we need for exciting projects. Best of all, I'll show you just how easy it is to use, even if you are a beginner. Let's dive in and see what it has to offer. About a year ago, I came across the company Soldered. You might remember them from my previous project, the Color e-paper weather station, which turned out great. They are a European-based company located in Croatia, and their philosophy really resonates with me. They are makers creating products for makers. They are passionate about making stuff, just like we are, and that's why I think they know exactly how to design and build a useful board. The Inkplate 2 board immediately caught my attention from their lineup of products. It is a small tricolor e-paper board, which is exactly what I needed for some projects I have been planning. I have always wanted to experiment with a tricolor e-paper display, and luckily, Soldered offers a board that not only features this technology, but also makes it incredibly easy to work with. Make sure to stick around the end of the video, where I'll share the projects I'm considering for this board and host a poll to let you decide which one we will bring to life. So let's talk about what makes the Inkplate 2 so interesting. It is built around a 2.13-inch tricolor e-paper display, which I think is perfect for compact projects. The screen can show three colors, red, black, and white, and has a resolution of 212 by 104 pixels. While it is definitely low resolution compared to the modern high-definition screens, it is still good for an e-paper display. With 111 dpi, the screen is sharp enough for simple graphics and text. What's awesome though is that the e-paper only uses power when the screen updates. That means once the image is on the display, it stays there without drawing any power, making it perfect for battery-powered projects. The refresh rate is about 15 seconds, which is standard for this type of e-paper technology. This means it is not suitable for anything that needs quick updates, like animation or real-time displays. However, it works well for static content, such as showing temperature, a to-do list, or other information that doesn't change often. The board uses an ESP32 microcontroller, a powerful chip, with two 32-bit cores running at 160 MHz. It has 320 kilobytes of RAM, 8 MB of PSRAM, and 4 MB of flash memory, giving it enough power to handle advanced tasks. It also comes with built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, making it easy to connect to other devices or the internet. Plus, the board has an external antenna, which improves the signal strength and range for better wireless performance. The board is also great at saving energy. In low power mode, it uses only 8 microamps, which means it can run for months on a lithium-ion battery. It also has a built-in battery charger, so you can connect a battery directly and charge it easily using the USB Type-C port. With its combination of power, wireless features, and energy efficiency, this board is perfect for portable or long-lasting projects like sensors, clocks, or anything that doesn't need the display to update often. You can download and 3D print an enclosure for the Inkplate 2 to give it a nice finishing touch. I used wood filament for mine and it turned out great. It looks natural and unique, matching the e-paper display perfectly. Soldered provides the file so it is easy to print and put together. If you don't have a 3D printer, don't worry, you can also buy the board with a pre-made enclosure, which saves time. Now that we know what the board offers, the next step is programming it. And this is where things get even better. The board supports both Arduino and MicroPython, but I chose to program it with Arduino because I am more familiar with it. Additionally, Arduino code runs faster and generally consumes less power compared to MicroPython, making it a great choice for projects where efficiency is critical. If you are curious about the differences and want to learn more, I have made a video on this topic. be sure to check it out for a detailed comparison. Using the step-by-step instructions from the company, I got my first program running in less than 5 minutes. The process was straightforward. This was very different from my experience with a similar board from a Chinese vendor, where I spent hours trying to find the right instructions and troubleshoot issues. To start using the Inkplate 2 board, the first step is to add its board definitions file to the Arduino IDE. We have to go to File, Preferences, and in this field we have to paste this URL with the board definitions. Next, we need to open the Boards Manager tool by clicking on this icon. We have to search for Inkplate and press to install the Inkplate board definitions. Next, we need to install the Inkplate library. We have to open the Library Manager, search for Inkplate, and simply click Install. And that's it. After a few seconds, our setup is complete. Now we have to plug in the board, select the correct board type and USB port, and we are ready to start programming. Simple, isn't it? Let's dive into creating something. I have written a basic script that displays a Hello World message and uses all three colors that the display supports. If the code looks familiar, it is because the Inkplate library is built on the Adafruit GFX library, so it is very easy to use. Adafruit GFX is popular because it is simple and works well, and the Inkplate library uses the same commands. If you have used the Adafruit GFX library before, you will already know how to use most of the methods it offers. For example, you can use methods like setTextSize to change the size of the text, setCursor to position it, and fillRect to draw rectangles. These commands make it easy to create graphics, text, and interactive displays. Even if you are new to Adafruit GFX, the library is well documented and there are many examples to help you get started. Now, let's explore some sample projects that highlight the board's capabilities. The library we have just installed includes dozens of examples that can save you a lot of time when developing your own projects. Many essential features, like connecting to Wi-Fi, downloading images from the web, or using data APIs to fetch information like weather update or stock prices, are already built in. This allows you to focus on the creative aspects of your project rather than spending time writing basic functionality from scratch. One of the most interesting examples included with the board is the cryptocurrency tracker. It is a great showcase of what you can do with this technology. This project retrieves live data about Bitcoin from the web and displays it on the screen. How cool is that? Now, while I am not a huge fan of cryptocurrencies myself, I can really appreciate the potential of this project. It shows how you can use any available API on the internet to fetch data and present it in a clean, visual way. Whether it's stock prices, weather forecasts, or something else entirely, this example highlights how flexible and practical the board can be. Very cool. Let's load another example program, this time a sketch that downloads an image from the internet and displays it on the e-paper screen. As we have mentioned, this display can only show three colors, red, black, and white. So, how does it handle an image with many colors? Each pixel on the display can only be one of the three colors, but we can use a technique called dithering to create the illusion of more colors. Dithering works by adding patterns or noise to the image. These patterns mix the available colors in a way that tricks the eye into seeing smoother transitions and more detail, especially when viewed from a distance. Let's see an example. A black and white image of a cat. From a distance, it looks fine, but when we take a closer look, we can see that it is made up of a pattern of black and white pixels. This is the magic of dithering at work, allowing the limited colors to represent much more than they actually can. However, don't expect crystal clear images, like you will see on a modern color screen. While the dithering technique does a great job with smooth transitions, the overall quality depends on the resolution and capabilities of the display. I have some very exciting projects in mind to build with this board, and the first one I want to share is a weather display with a vintage analog-style thermometer user interface. This project is inspired by those classic old-school thermometers and will beautifully combine a retro aesthetic with modern technology. The interface will feature a vertical thermometer with both Fahrenheit and Celsius scales, just like the one you see here. A red bar will dynamically update to show the current temperature, giving it a nostalgic, classic look. But that's not all. This project will also include a back-end web server that provides additional data such as the current temperature, humidity, and barometric pressure with high accuracy. It will even include historical graphs for each value. It is incredible what makers can create today with such affordable tools and minimal effort. This project is coming next week, so be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay updated. You won't want to miss it. Also, I have three more projects in mind. A web radio with an enclosure inspired by Dieter Ram's fantastic radio, which will use this e-paper board as the display and the main processor. A to-do list with some buttons for input and a habit tracker. I can't do them all, so I have created a poll which you can find in the community tab of the channel. Please vote on the one project to build in the coming weeks. Working with this display is really fun. It is versatile, easy to use, and opens up endless possibilities for creative projects. Now you can click here to watch the analog-looking weather station project. You are going to love it.